In this video, we present to you the results of the Green Mind Award project Bernoulliborg, the building of sustainability. This project was proposed and implemented by Faris Nizamic and Tuan and Nguyen, two PhD students of the Distributed Systems Research Group from the University of Groningen. The goal of the project was to improve sustainability aspects at the University of Groningen, focusing specifically on a building of the Faculty of Mathematics and Natural Sciences, the Bernoulliborg.
Welcome to Bernoulliborg,
the building of sustainability.
This was a very complex project covering several aspects of sustainability, energy, water and waste, as well as including multidisciplinary cross-teamwork between researchers and project managers, facility managers, software developers, manufacturers and maintenance workers. These are the results of the project per affected building subsystem. The waste separation process has been completely changed within the building. Instead of being able to dispose only general waste and water, the occupants of the Bernoulliborg now have the opportunity to separate two additional types of waste, plastic and cans. 30 new waste separation bins have been deployed across the building and all old bins for general waste have been removed from the offices and common spaces. Plastic and cans are now separated, and measurement results show that this change in process has increased the amount of separated paper by 83% and reduced the amount of general waste by 22%. It is also interesting to notice that in only 1 week's time, 123 kilograms of plastic were recycled.
I like the initiative. I think the university has to be sustainable, and we all have to be aware of the problems of waste and the plastic soup in the ocean. And recycling, as the way you do it, it helps stop these problems.
To save water, water-saving devices have been installed on all the water faucets within the building. Previously, a lot of water was unnecessarily flowing when the building occupants washed their hands or their dishes after lunch. 35 water-saving aerators in total have been added to the faucets, and this way the water flow from the faucets is reduced by up to 50%. Looking at the total water savings, we see that for the whole building the water saving is 11%. The total water saving for 1 year is equivalent to one average swimming pool.
I think it makes people more aware that they flush 10 liters of water a day, because you really see the sticker in front of you. Because of the device on the faucet, there was less splashing and the water was more controlled.
When it comes to electricity savings, we focused on electricity savings by using smart control of lights and PCs that are significant consumers in commercial office buildings. Within this project, central control of sleep timeouts of desktop PCs has been developed and deployed within the whole building. The solution ensures that PCs are in energy-saving mode whenever they are not used. In case occupants have to have their PC on for longer periods of time, for example to run experiments or for remote access to their machines, they can disable PC sleep timeout control. The solution saves approximately 1 to 5 euros per PC per month, which means significant monthly savings given the number of PCs used within the building. In the restaurant of the Bernoulliborg, the issue was that the lights were on for at least 12 hours every day. That was not necessary as the restaurant is used only for 2 to 3 hours per day. Now, lights are programmatically controlled based on presence detection and light level detection. This is done by 70 sensors and actuators. This way it is ensured that lights are turned off whenever no one is present in the restaurant or when the level of natural light is sufficiently high. That way usage of restaurant lights has been reduced from 12 hours per day to approximately 3 hours per day. Taking into account all the lights and their consumption, we save about 5,000 kilowatt hours per year. That is equivalent to the consumption of more than one average Dutch household. Electricity consumption is significantly influenced by the behavior of the building occupants. Research shows that the inefficiencies resulting from the occupants' behavior can be between 10 and 30% of the total building consumption. To tackle this issue and to influence the occupants' behavior, an energy dashboard has been installed at the entrance of the building to provide feedback on the total electricity consumption of all building occupants. This way, the occupants can see the real-time consumption of the building and decide which saving actions to take to reduce this consumption. Having dashboards like this definitely helps to inform the users and raise awareness on the current consumption. It is expected that using the energy dashboard, electricity consumption of this building will be reduced by 3 to 9%. Other ways can also be used to raise awareness of the building occupants. Promotional material has been placed all over the building, with useful information on how to preserve energy and water. Different stickers and posters have been printed and placed all over the building to remind people of energy and water preservation and to motivate them to conserve resources. It is expected that this action will also have an impact on the mindset of the occupants, which should be reflected in a reduction of monthly energy and water bills for this building. This pioneering project shows that the University of Groningen and its employees want to move towards more sustainable buildings and a more sustainable working environment. Besides the concrete outcomes mentioned before, it has also stimulated additional research efforts and produced additional scientific outputs. Moreover, the project leaders will proceed with research valorization and commercialization in order to try to multiply the effects and reuse the benefits of this project in other buildings of the university and beyond. In this way, we are making buildings energy smart and sustainable.
Yeah, we want to be our buildings sustainable, all of them, because we think it's the smart thing to do. It not only saves us money, but we get happy people, and that's the important thing.